Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT. And in this video, I want to talk to you about how long it takes to study for the MCAT. When it comes to something like the MCAT and my students ask me, hey Leia, how long should I study? Well, we have a problem because this isn't a simple question that you can Google and find an answer. This is something that you have to slowly figure out based on what you learn about yourself. As a future doctor, you're a scientist. A patient comes to you with a problem, you have a hypothesis, you act on that hypothesis, and then you evaluate the goals. Well, why not treat you as the first experiment? The hypothesis will be what you think it'll take. And then you'll evaluate the steps and how long it takes you to get through those steps. That's a long-winded way of saying, instead of just giving you a number, I want to show you what you need to figure out so that you can figure out your timeline. When it comes to preparing for the MCAT, I have a three-phase approach that you can learn about in the link below. Phase one is the foundation. That's where you learn the content. That's where you go through subject by subject, physics, general chemistry, organic chemistry, biochemistry, biology, psychology, sociology, and start on cars. That's when you learn, understand, and memorize so that you can get to phase two, where you're going to do in-depth, hardcore practice. And once you feel ready, you go into phase three. You go through a few weeks of full-length run-throughs, and then you know you're ready. So how long does that take? Well, that depends on you. For phase one, you want to see how long it takes you to get through content. And that's something I cover in a separate phase one video link below. But this depends on how many hours you can study a week, how quickly you learn the information, how fresh you are with the information, meaning did you just finish your physics class or has it been 5 years since you took physics? Did you recently ace a biochem class or are you self-studying biochem because you're not going to take it before your MCAT? These questions are custom to you and you have to figure out based on how much time I have in a given week and how much I get through in a week, how many weeks is it going to take me to get through all of the content? I have seen everything from students getting through content in as little as 2 months, but this is for students who are strong in the sciences from their classes and are studying full time. And I have seen students take as much as 6 months because they have work, they have family, they have classes. It's been a while since they've seen the material, or maybe they're even self-studying because there are certain classes they haven't taken. Once you finish content, and ideally a couple of full lengths in phase one, you go into the practice phase. This is where you work on taking practice exams, understanding where and why you're losing points, and then working out those issues to make sure that it's not a problem on the next exam. The duration for phase two, again, depends on you. How many points do you have to improve before you're ready for your MCAT? If you're a student who only needs to go up another 2 to 3 points based on where you left off in phase one, you probably need just a few weeks for phase two. But if you're a student who needs to increase by more than 10 points, it's going to take you a lot longer. So once again, figure out how many points can I improve on every full length? How frequently am I taking those full lengths? And how long is that going to take? For example, if your average full length jump is 2 points, and you take a full length every other week, that comes to 4 points a month at the minimum, because you always want to leave a little bit of buffer for your plateau. I recommend a minimum of 2 months for phase two, because no matter how well you score, you still want to have time to get familiar with the style, the format, and just get good at the test itself. I have seen students need as much as 4 or even 6 months for phase two, when they don't have a lot of time to study, or when the required jump is so high that they just have to go through slowly and carefully, bringing up their scores 1 to 2 points at a time. And finally, phase three, I recommend just a month because this is an opportunity to just have a run through of test day for 4 weeks in a row to make sure that you're confident with the routine going into the exam so that it almost feels like muscle memory. Now, I realize I haven't actually answered the question of how long you should study for the MCAT, but hopefully you understand why, and more specifically, the questions that you're going to have to ask yourself every step of the way to make sure that you're on track. I'm going to add a couple of resources in the description that I want you to do for homework, because this will be your next step in figuring out the timeline. The first thing you need is your baseline, so you know where you're starting out. Then you need your targets to know where you're going and to be able to figure out how much you have to improve based on where you started and where you're finishing up. Then you need to have your daily schedule where you know how much time you're devoting to MCAT prep on a weekly basis without burning out. This is critical, and without sacrificing your other commitments. This is a long, long process, so you can't neglect everything else that you have to do in this time. And finally, watch the phase one evaluation video so that you can measure your progress based on what you've already done and be able to estimate how much longer it's going to take. But before you dive into your homework, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click that bell icon so that you don't miss notifications of future videos. And then let me know in the comments below what you found most helpful in this video and which MCAT prep aspects you want me to cover in upcoming videos.